4 years after it was largely freed from ISIL, construction in Iraq's western Anbar province is booming. Once complete, this mall in the provincial capital Ramadi aims to be the largest of its kind in Iraq.
These projects are needed in this province, and according to our assessment and feasibility study, we believe these projects will be successful.
Precious jobs have been created at a time when Iraq suffers from economic downturn and rising poverty rates.
Before this project started, I was unemployed. The project helped many young people to get jobs, and it has helped reduce unemployment in the province.
It's estimated Anbar has a non-oil sector investment portfolio worth $2 billion, one of the highest among Iraq's 18 provinces. The director of Anbar's investment commission says the relative stability around Ramadi over the past few years has created a business-friendly environment.
Anbar's society believes in the authority of the civilian government. Because of that, we haven't had any armed groups for years. No one is allowed to carry weapons except for the government security forces.
The local government in Anbar wants to develop vast, untapped mineral and gas resources and says it needs to attract more foreign investors, especially from the Gulf. But the Sunni province is demanding more leeway to circumvent the Shia-led government in Baghdad, known for its cumbersome bureaucracy and widespread corruption.
We hope the central government gives us more authority in energy and electricity production. Many international companies propose projects in Anbar, but because of our limited authority and the complicated procedures of the central government, things have been delayed.
The local government's push for investment doesn't just aim to develop Anbar's economy, it also underpins its political ambitions for greater autonomy from the central government in Baghdad. But some businessmen say decentralization alone won't solve their problems. This investor says it has taken more than 2 years to complete the paperwork for this hypochlorite plant and blames the local and central governments equally. He has spent millions of dollars but is yet to receive a license. He didn't want to speak on camera for fear it might further complicate the process. Experts say until the government overhauls its regulations, few foreign investors will take the risk of setting up shop here. Simona Foltin, Al Jazeera, in Iraq's western Anbar province.